Hi, so this is a clip about how to do the sign test. So, the sign test is the only stats test that you will have, you could potentially be asked to do in the exam. So if in the exam paper it asks you to work out the observed value of something, you know it's a sign test. Right, now how do you know when to do a sign test? Very quickly, this is on page 20 in your packs. So you're looking for a difference between the data. It has to be repeated measures design, so you have to have the same participants in each condition, and it has to be nominal data, really simply. Often, to be honest, it isn't nominal data, but you turn it into nominal data. But don't worry too much about that, because if they're asking you to work it out in the exam, obviously they're going to get you to make it into nominal data, or it already is. So what do you do now? Let's do the example that's in your pack, which is your energy drink example again. So here, if you have a look, So participant one, they drank a litre of energy drink and then they did the task, and they were recorded speaking 110 words. And then when they did it with water, it was 122 words. So how do you convert that into nominal data? Well, simply all that you do is you take away one of the scores from the other. Now actually it doesn't matter which way round you do it, as long as you consistently do it the way that you do it for every single bit of data. So what do I mean by that? So for participant one, if you decide you're going to got 110, take away 122, if you do that for every single participant, then it won't make a difference to the answer, and it wouldn't matter if you did it the other way around, as long as you did it for every participant. So let's have a look. So participant one, 110, take away 122, what's that? Minus 12. So that would, it's a sign test after all, that's how it, where it comes from, that would get a minus because it's minus 12, yeah? The next one then, 59 take away 45, that's plus 14, so that gets a plus, yeah? Now, you do that for every single participant, always taking away in the same way. But what happens if, say, participant 14, if you look, they got 103 with both. That just comes out as no difference, yeah? So there's no sign for that. And there's something we do with that a little bit later. So what do you do next? So you'd go through the data, doing minus or plus, and then you have to work out your observed value, remember, or your calculated value answer. And all you have to do, there's no complicated maths, is you work out, you add up all the pluses and the minuses, yeah? So if you go through here, for pluses, there are 13 pluses, and we have 7 minuses, yeah? So you go through and you work out, and your observed value, which we call here S. So in psychology, for each of the stats tests, we call it the observed value, but we always give it a letter or a few letters. So the sign test, the observed value is S. And for every single time, your value of S is the sign with the least amount of values, yeah? So here, what is it? It's 7, yeah? Because it's less than 13, so your value of S is 7. Ta-da, that's your observed value. That's literally how you work it out. What do you do with it next? You want to work out if it's significant. So you need to know, remember what you need to know? What do you need to know? You need to know your level of significance. You need to know N, which is the amount of participants. And you need to know whether it's one-tailed or two-tailed. Now this is where we go back to here. So our N, now it's not simply 20 because there were 20 participants. If you have any participants where there is no difference, where it's the same, you ignore that. So if you look here on our example, there is one person where there was no difference, so therefore you ignore that score. So N equals 19 instead of 20. That's really, really important, okay? Are you following me? Good. And that's all that you need to do. So is it significant or not? Right, now, your critical value table for the sign test is on page 15. So if you flip back to that for me, got it? Good, good, good. Now, we have said our critical value we're looking for is N is 19, We've said that it's non-directional, and a level of significance, if in doubt, it's always 0.05. Work out the critical value now. Look at your table. Yeah, so go to 19. Go to, we've said it's two-tailed, and go to 0.05. So what's your critical value? Have you found it? Your critical value is 4. Yeah? So our critical value is 4. Now, we haven't actually talked about how you then decide if it's significant or not, yeah? So we've got 7 and we've got 4. How do you know if it's significant? Now, on the top of your critical value table, it will tell you whether this needs to be bigger than that in order for it to be significant. We're going to look at an easy way for you to remember it in the next clip. But if you have a look at your table, it says value of S must be less than or equal to the critical value for it to be significant. So look, is 7 less than or equal to 4? No, it's not, is it? So therefore, in this case, our findings are not significant. So what do we have to do? We have to reject the alternative hypothesis and accept the null hypothesis because it's not worked. And that is how you do the sign test. That's simply all that it is. Now, if you go to the back of your pack, there's lots of examples that you can practice to check whether you really do understand it. And I think for your homework, you're going to be doing some of them, so check with that. That's it, sign test done.